Hey guys, so this video is going to be my most personal one yet, and I hope it will leave you feeling confident in your skills and motivated to practice and make ugly art. Yes, ugly art, because let me tell you, even nowadays, I make ugly art all the time. Maybe one in three or four paintings that I do turns out bad, and I don't even bat an eye to it. I'm so used to it. I just move on to the next one. But usually, I finish them. Why, you ask, if it's already doomed? Simple, for experimentation and practice. If a piece is already ruined, what does it matter if I mess up some more? And in this way, I have discovered so many new techniques that I wouldn't have otherwise. For example, this portrait of Audrey Hepburn was going well in the beginning, but I kept getting looser and looser and was listening to really lively music, and I have a problem with really controlling my strokes when I do that. So when I got to the painting part, I sort of went wild and just messed up completely from the get-go by using too much paint. I mean, look at this. So I stopped filming, and then I walked away, and then came back to it and finished the piece just for practice. But guess what? This actually turned out beautiful. It's one of my more recent favorite pieces. I even discovered a bunch of new techniques along the way, like that gold on black. I love that. So the lesson is not to trash your pieces or give up too early. This happens rarely. Usually when a piece is doomed, it is doomed. But when it's saved like this, it's a nice surprise. Sometimes I get so into the painting or a certain technique that I completely overdo it. For example, this was done with the paper upright, so there was a lot of dripping. And I don't have much experience with that painting technique, so I got a little too excited and went over the top. I still finished the piece, but it's not good enough to share with social media or my portfolio. But I regret nothing, because now I understand the dripping technique much better, and I know better now when to stop and how not to overdo it and not to overdo backgrounds. With this bird, I was using pencils with watercolors, and I was very new to the technique. It was only like 2 weeks ago, so I was experimenting, and I didn't like the results. It turned out really flat. Again, this was a lesson learned and taught me how not to use pencils with watercolors, but I have done a lot of paintings that I really enjoy, but I wouldn't be able to do those if I didn't mess up first. I mess up all the time, since I tend to be more loose and experimental. But I'm always rewarded with so many new techniques and discoveries. I also think that the more you mess up and the more risks you take, the faster you grow in your art. But if you're a beginner artist and you think this stuff is not so bad, or that if I think this is bad, your work must really suck, well, let me show you my work from only 7 years ago. I just want to inspire you guys, but this is kind of embarrassing. So 7 years seems like a long time, but it's not really. I have never shared this before, but I filled in this whole sketchbook when I was about 17 years old. And as you can see, I've made a lot of progress since then. I was starting to get serious about art at this age, even though I doodled and loved coloring books all my life. And I want you guys to really think about that. I started getting serious about art at 17, and I made a lot of progress really fast. So it's never too late to start. I mean, I don't care if you're 30, 50, you can always, in a couple years, pick it up quickly if you just practice a lot. I used to not like anything that I drew, but I kept drawing because I just love to draw, and I filled out the whole sketchbook very quickly, and that's the reason I improved so much so fast. This was actually the first sketchbook that I ever finished completely. It's all about practice, practice, and practice, and practice, and more practice, and practice. So draw and paint and do whatever else you like to do just because you like to do it. Do it while watching TV, do it while you're bored, do it while you're on the subway in the commute or whatever. You don't have to share your work until you feel comfortable in doing so. And don't do it just to improve. It shouldn't be a chore. Do it because it's fun, and keep doing it, and soon you'll love what you make more than you won't. Just know that you'll never reach a point where you'll stop making mistakes, and that's a good thing. It's a good thing to always learn and grow. If you make ugly art, it doesn't mean you're a bad artist. Every artist out there, no matter how experienced, like, I don't care if you're Michelangelo, everybody makes art they don't like from time to time and makes mistakes and has to start over. The only way to avoid that is to play it extremely safe with lots of planning. But this limits growth. There really shouldn't be a fear of making mistakes. Most artists don't share their failed work, even though they have piles of it. Thus, the misconception that true artists don't make mistakes is born. This is why I am sharing this video with you, to show you that I'm not embarrassed with my failed art. It's completely natural to make ugly art, and I love all of these pieces for being my teachers. The more risks you take, the more ugly art you will make, but also the faster you will find your style, grow your skills, and get something really unique under your art tool belt. So take risks, make art, make ugly art, and repeat. Trust me, the fun is in the journey, in the improvement, in the learning. I love learning new skills, and that's why I'm learning how to paint with gouache now. It's actually really, really challenging. I'm not gonna lie, it's so different from watercolors, but it's so rewarding and so fun to start from square one and work my way up. Think about it, if everything came easily to you, would it be as rewarding? No. So embrace the process and love everything that you do. I hope this video inspired you to keep creating and shows that it's all just persistence and the love of the craft. Perfection is overrated, boring, and unrealistic. So stay awesome, guys, and I'll see you in the next video.